basically, what has happened, I think that you have seen that we have sought the, I was summoned to come to a meeting with the Minister of Transport, Honorable Mawere, where Andrew also appeared. The meeting was inconclusive, and it was then said that we should have an executive committee meeting. We've been waiting. They have said that the meeting will take place on Monday. Yesterday it has not taken place. And I think that if you remember to the time at the OIDC, what we have said is that this nomination, according to CAF, is it Article 15, or is it Article 15, Paragraph 5, it does say, you know, that the nomination has to come from the National Association. In light of that, you know, I have reached out, tried to reach out to Andrew myself. I did SMS him and call him on Friday, and fortunately did not pick, but he did call me back on Saturday when we were going to the barrio of Mr. Mamba Kalenga, Professor Mamba Kalenga. And he said that we should be able to meet Monday, but you know, I wanted that we meet Saturday so that we could be able to resolve this issue. Sunday, nothing. I haven't heard nothing. So I took it upon myself today to write to the executive committee of FAZ to say this nomination, we've been waiting. Everybody's in the race for this nomination. There's a few days, but we're still in the race. The Football Association of Zambia has until, you know, today not called an executive committee meeting. So we're asking them to see if you know, the nomination could be, you know, I think that if you look at our football today in Zambia, it would have been better, you know, that as an incumbent, maybe Kalusha remains in CAF and Andrew, you know, and the executive, they concentrate on, you know, winning games and football and local. You still have a handful at the local level, so which was going to be paramount for the Zambian people. So, and in terms of if there is any check of some sort, I think that it would be up to Football Association of Zambia to write to CAF to say if this, or to FIFA to say, is these people Andrew and Kalusha eligible to start? Because I don't think that they can make that call. So it is up to them to write to CAF. The Confederation of African Football, I've been able, the legal committee gave me the authority to say that I should write to the Football Association of Zambia to say to them that I am an active and current member of the executive, the CAF executive committee. So as such, I am not obliged to go through any test of anything. So, and then they referred to the letter which CAF sent to me on the 7th of February, which was referring to that I was coming back into football after, you know, the period that was last year. So this is the situation for the moment. So we're still in the race. Hopefully, you know, Zambia can have a candidate on the 31st of May in 2 days, I hope that we can still make that.
But based on what has been happening so far, as determined as you are, Andrew is also very determined, the current president, Mr. Andrew Kamanga, and yet there's only supposed to be one person. What do you make of the need for an integrity test when, on the other hand, one might argue that the letter that has been sent out by CAF does not actually require national associations to conduct integrity tests?
Well, it's crystal clear. There's no going around. I think the letter from CAF, you know, which they said that it should send, has been sent to CAF. But it's the interpretation. If people want to interpret it in a different way, that's not my, it's not my, me, up to me to decide. But CAF, you know, will be able. In fact, I mean, they should write the letters today if they want. You know, I think that it would be better for them to write to CAF to ask if Andrew or Kalusha is eligible to start.
From what you explained earlier, if I get you right, you are saying that you have no problems with Andrew concentrating on the past presidency here, especially that the elections next year. And then it could also lead you to concentrate on CAF. Let me get it very clear. Are you saying you are willing to leave Andrew, much as you haven't said whether you run next year or not, to leave him to run local football as long as he supports you internationally?
No, I thought it was going to be the better medium because you have one incumbent, Zambian, Zambia being a Christian nation. You have one incumbent, and then who's on the CAF, let him stay there. And then you have, I think that you, it's not up to me. I think the Zambian people will be able to judge. 24 hours in football is a long time. So, you know, this is their mandate, and they have a mandate that they have been fulfilling from 2016. So, to be better for them, I think that they have a lot more on their hands, you know, than what CAF will be able to provide. So, this is what I think.
What do you make of information circulating that the outcome of the integrity test here is already predetermined and that you'll be failed?
No, I think that it's a pity because, you know, Zambia acts on international scale. Zambia is not acting in isolation. The rules that govern football, you know, we have to follow the FIFA statutes, we have to follow the CAF statutes, and then we come to the local. So it cannot be, you know, because we are trying to go to a place. I think it will send the wrong picture to the people, and I think that the people should know. They should be informed. That is why we're trying to say to them that information is key in this matter, because you can't then try, you know, to find solutions where there are no solutions, or to bring laws where there are no laws. Because at the end of the day, if they're there to say that, you know, CAF tomorrow will write to them to say Kalu is available to them. So who's going to look? They're going to look bad in the eyes of the Zambian people and in the eyes of the world.
Do you lastly, do you at all recognize the role of the Integrity and Ethics Committee?
It's up to you guys to judge.
All right. Okay.
Yeah. Thank you.
Okay.